Yeah. Okay, it's 9 o'clock. I think we shall be started. So just to let you all know, my topic of today is actually an introduction to web application security. Not really very in-depth, it's just an introduce for developers who are actually started doing web application. So who do security here actually? Okay, that's good. Okay, just to introduce about myself, okay? Actually, I'm a developer for 5 years. I'm currently as a cybersecurity software engineer. Okay, I'm taking a part-time master in knowledge engineering. I have a computer science degree in digital security. Okay, how do you go about securing your web application? Okay, testing and verification. So how many of you are developer here actually? Okay, that's good. So normally when you do testing, okay, you do functional testing. A lot of times they forgot about security testing. Okay. So there's actually a lot of missing things that you are not covering in functional testing. Okay, security tester need to think out of the box. So what is the strategy is to secure at the source. So in the past, we do SDLC, Software Development Lifecycle. But right now, we've moved into Secure Software Development Lifecycle. So there are some of the methodology, okay, out there right now. Like Microsoft, they have their own documentation on how to do secure web development. How do you? There's a CMM. There's a OWASP AVVS. Okay, I'm not going to cut touch on this. I'll just briefly introduce you to those only who are developer and not been touching into security right now. Okay, this is a Microsoft Secure Development Lifecycle. There's a training requirement, designing, implementation, verification. So every step of them, they have their own unique. Of doing things. Actually, my viewpoint, there's a lot of methodology out there to do secure development lifecycle, but in reality, we need to strike a balance. How much need do you need to secure your products or your web application? Is there too much or too little? Okay, just to briefly introduce, there's actually Open Web Application Security Project, OWASP. Okay, they actually it's an online community. They actually publish documentation about application security, and there's some standard you can use. Okay, OWASP Top 10 is a powerful awareness document for web application security. Sorry, am I boring you all out? What you already know? I'm so sorry, I'm just trying to introduce those who are new developers. I saw a lot of students coming into this event, so I want to educate them about what is web security. So actually, they give a standards of a lot of vulnerabilities. They're actually top 10 injection, broken authentication, session management, cross-site scripting. So how do you all manage all this? How do you all do testing? Okay, they actually release ASVS standards. Okay, just show you that there are reports. actually they released a very well report on how to do testing. You can actually take a look. How to do cross-site scripting, how to do authentication, tests, all this. So OWASP, they have actually verification level. There's a first level for all software. The second level is for application that concerns sensitive data with required protection. Okay, third level is for the most critical applications that performs sensitive data. So we can actually derive this. Okay, they have a list of actually what should you test for every items for your web applications. Okay, for their standard, is at least all web applications should meet at least level 2. So there's a checklist you can actually download from OWASP itself to actually follow to verify that if your web application does actually meet any standards. Example, is the all the checklists you can download at the OWASP website itself. This is just a guideline. There's no need for you to follow strictly. You can actually take some of the guideline to follow and not to follow. But from my point of view, you at least should meet a level 2 of this documentation. So how do you do testing? First of all, you do recons, you do mapping, you do discovery. Okay, exploit is for pen tester. We are going to touch on this. Correct. So how do you do recons? Visiting their website. Actually, there's a lot of tools out there actually to actually help you do mapping and discovery. For example, there's Nmap and Zenmap to pop up, maybe to identify what are the servers your web application using. Is there anything you can use as a opening? For example, there's I take our event website. Okay, we go ahead and scan their ports. Okay, this is a website I use normally to scan whether this website, what is open, what type of port is open, is it secure? Okay, then we do a sort of study of the website first before we do anything more in depth. Okay, we can see that the server types. Okay, you can do some specific server type of attack in a while. We know their servers. We know what is open. HTTP is open. HTTPS is open. So for some other website that are less secure, you can actually see if there's a SMB, if that SMB is open, they are trying to steal your data. How many of you know the Microsoft authentication attack? Okay, by having a SMB image in the website, I actually can get your window locking account, window live login account, if your password hash. So before you actually go into all this website, do you actually study what is happening on the website itself? So I suggest before you do anything, always scan through what they are trying to do. Okay, I actually do a mini project outside on how the hacker actually steal your window password. There's a SME protocol that actually 3.0 is over the net. Actually, you can steal their login password hash. And then with the session key, you can actually reverse the password and he got all your access to your Microsoft account. So these are the service details of this of our current website. So from all this, you can actually map out what you want to do. Okay, the next stage of this, I would say, is to use some free availability available software. How many of you use Burpsuite or Zenmap? OWASP Zen. That's good. That's good. So you know how to use, correct? It's a very powerful tool. I recommend Zen. It's because it's open source and free. OWASP actually give these free tools compared to Burps. Burps, you need to have license. There's actually free trial version, but I don't think it's that useful actually, because you can't save the reports itself. So let me take some random website and attack. Not recommend to do, but I just for demo only. He actually can map out the whole website path and folders. Example, this is a website you want to do. You actually can attack and do a spider crawl. Okay, for this, there's actually a more in-depth tutorial you can get online or go and visit on how to do actually, most websites do authentication. Okay. Do authentications. So you need to configure that to actually use your web browser as a proxy to actually map out do Ajax spidering and do password authentication automatically way. So this is a very, very good tool that you should explore if you are new to web security. Okay, for time-consuming purposes, you can have reports on what type of security loophole it is. Okay, I did some scan for some of the one of the website way beforehand, and this is their vulnerabilities by the host itself, and this is their report. You can see what you should actually close up. What is critical in your web system? What should you do? And they actually give you suggestion on how do you actually do the patching or cover up this problem. So a lot of problem today is actually web security. It's not actually the vulnerability of things, but actually the developer itself forgotten to do something, like they said, forget to do verification on all inputs. So there are actually libraries from OWASP itself you can actually use as a guide, like development guides. They actually have open libraries itself for you to use for your development. They will check your input string, all this. Anybody got any question at this point of time? I can. Or anything you want to know. Am I too dry, or this is what you already know? I recommend you to actually go and read up on OWASP. Actually, they have very good templates and a lot of open source tools you can use from this.
Yeah. So, what would your recommendation be? In terms of vulnerability scanning, right? Mm-hmm. You scan it every other month, in your experience, what would be the recommended period of time frame, like you
can
update your security tool and then run the scan.
Mm-hmm. Actually, if you are going for a perfect security, every time you do a release, But there's a point that how much work you want to do, releasing the product first or securing your product. You must strike a balance. Mm-hmm. Too much security delay the timeline. And it delay the whole project. It's more harder to do. Then too little become vulnerability. So you must strike a balance. Know what is your asset. Know what you want to protect. Mm-hmm. If let's say you're just doing a normal website or systems that only do normal data, not very sensitive, maybe you just want to do the top 10 vulnerabilities. The top 10. Like SQL injections, authentications, cross-site scripting, you want to cover that. That this top 10 will actually maybe solve quite a lot of problems. Those outside of the top 10 are real hacker trying to do tackle your site. That type of people are very, very extreme case that maybe you need to consider after you release your product. Any other questions?
So yes. Maybe for new people,
yes,
that is totally new to web security.
Yes.
So besides OWASP, so do you look into having some tool to help, or do you look into the methodology that matters to just maybe for this discussion?
Okay. I think that you should follow some methodologies first. Identify what are the use cases. Like there's a Microsoft SDLC, the Secure Development Lifecycle. You don't need to follow strictly, but it's good to understand what they are looking out for. I suggest at least 50% of what they are actually talking about, you should actually consider implementing. So if for people who are using agile methodology, there's something, don't forget the evil user story. So So you must always consider from other side. Normally people only consider the functionality, the features of the product. You cover functional tests for all your the features itself, but you forget about user that don't follow your user guide. User that don't follow your recommendation, they always try to do something out of the box. So you must remember to actually consider that area also.
Thank you.
Thank you. Any last question before I end it? Yes.
I'm working in operations, so a lot of this, like for example, that would be typically the role of an operations team to say, well, you have a lockdown SMB, for instance, but whereas other SQL injections would be more of a developer detail.
Yes.
So, but for OWASP, that covers the whole range of things, right?
Yes, it's actually a standard for developer to follow and for operation to use as a guide to test their system itself. So you can consider a lot of good information from this community. Okay, I think that's about all for me. Thank you.